Hello students, once again I am here with inverse trigo functions. I will be taking this question. Simplify sine inverse of 3x negative 4x cube if x belongs to the closed interval minus half to half. So I will call this expression as y, and I will be substituting x by cos theta. So if you can just guess, I will be giving you a homework where I will ask you what happens if we put x at sine theta. Keep in mind this. So you can see theta is cos inverse of x, and now y will be sine inverse thrice cos theta minus 4 cos cube theta. You know this is negative of cos 3a, means cos 3 theta. I was referring to the formula. You know negative cos a is cos pi minus a. So let me write it: sine inverse cos pi minus 3 theta. Consequently, you know cos of a is sine pi by 2 minus a. So let me use that formula. So we will write it sine pi by 2 minus pi minus 3 theta. Moreover, in the next step, we know this will be 3 theta minus pi by 2. Now let us check if sine inverse of sine x is equal to x or not. You know x must be belonging to the PV branch range of sine inverse function. I am referring to this particular formula: sine inverse of sine x is equal to x if x belongs to the closed interval negative pi by 2 to pi by 2. So here it is being assumed to be x as referenced with this formula. So let me begin with this assumption of ours. We know that x is lying in this interval. Further, we know that x is cos of theta. So clearly theta will be, if we take cos inverse thoroughly, so it will be from pi by 3 to 2 pi by 3. We will just multiply by 3 throughout so that we have this interval. And now if we can subtract pi by 2 completely from these three expressions, so it will be pi by 2 less than equal to 3 theta minus pi by 2, which is further less than equal to 3 pi by 2. So you can see this expression lies in second and third quadrant. So sine inverse of sine x is not in reference with the PV branch range of sine inverse function. So what we will do, we will write sine inverse of sine 3 theta minus pi by 2 as pi minus of this angle. You know sine of a is sine pi minus a. So if I call it as a, so sine of a is sine pi minus a, which becomes in the upcoming steps as 3 pi by 2 minus 3 theta. Now if you refer to this step once again and just subtract pi from three values, so it will be minus pi by 2 3 theta minus 3 pi by 2, and this will be pi by 2. If we take negative of this, so we will have 3 pi by 2 minus 3 theta. This is this way and this is pi by 2. Now this value lies in the PV branch range of sine inverse function. So that means sine inverse of sine x, where x is belonging to the PV branch range, will give us x as it is. So now if I take 3 commons, we have pi by 2 minus theta, where theta is cos inverse of x. So it is pi by 2 minus cos inverse of x, and you know this is sine inverse of x. So that is the answer. You can see. Now friends, you can write your views in the comment section or WhatsApp me on my number 9650350480. Please subscribe to our channel and share with your friends. Bye bye.